Hello viewers, welcome to this session. Today we will analyze and interpret Heart of Darkness, which is written by Joseph Conrad. We shall explore the features of Marlowe and Kurtz, who are the main characters. We shall also study Victorian literature in the words of Joseph Conrad through Heart of Darkness. Let's see the introduction to the author. Joseph Conrad grew up in the Polish Ukraine, a large fertile land between Poland and Russia. It was a divided nation with four languages, four religions, and a number of different social classes. His father was Apollo Korzeniewski and mother Eva Bobrowska. Apollo devoted much of his time in literary and political activities, which brought in little money. He wrote a variety of plays and social satires, which had a tremendous influence on his son. Joseph Conrad was 7 years old when he lost his parents and became an orphan. The young boy became the ward of his uncle, who loved him dearly. He spent a few years in France, mastering his second language and the fundamentals of seamanship. He had many acquaintances in his circle, but his Bohemian friends introduced him to drama, opera, and theater. By 1878, Joseph made his way to England with the intention of becoming an officer on a British ship. He spent 20 years at sea, sometimes with long voyages and sometimes resting on land. A journey to the Congo in 1890 was Joseph's inspiration to write Heart of Darkness. He condemned colonialism, which is well documented in the books. In 1889, he wrote his first novel, Almayer's Folly. Conrad did not begin to learn English until he was 21 years old. Interestingly, he chose to write in English, his third language. His famous works during 1897 and 1911 are The Nigger of the Narcissus, Youth, Heart of Darkness, Lord Jim, Nostromo, The Secret Agent, and Under Westerner Eyes, and many others too. He experienced serious financial difficulties. His publication of Chance in 1914 gave him some level of commercial success. He returned to Poland and then traveled to America, where he died of a heart attack in 1924 at the age of 67. Heart of Darkness is a masterpiece that reveals Conrad's memories of his journey to the Congo. Many critics have called it the best short novel written in English. The central characters are Marlowe and Kurtz. It is a book about the discovery of unknown Africa. A reader cannot deny that the novel can be analyzed in terms of its focus on imperialism and colonialism and other events of the era. Europeans traveling to the underdeveloped and savage countries carry importance in the novel. Heart of Darkness provides a bridge between Victorian values and the ideals of modernism. Imperialism is, however, at the center of the novel. By 1890s, world's dark places were nominally under European control. European powers were stretched thin and cracks began to appear in the system. The white men living in distant places were threatened by riots, wars, and abandonment of commercial enterprises. Heart of Darkness is a narrative about the difficulty of understanding the world beyond the self and about the ability of a man to judge another. It was one of the first literary texts which provided a major view of European imperial activities. Critics made it controversial initially, but later admired, reinforcing its domestic values. The reader can also find the central themes of hypocrisy and absurdity. Conrad never tells where Heart of Darkness is set. It begins on a boat moored on the Thames, waiting for the tide to turn. He never gives a more exact location than this, because the Heart of Darkness is an imaginative location, a dark place that has no boundaries. Although the novel appears quite frightening to the readers of the 20th century, there is an exciting atmosphere in the center of an unexplored continent. The novel first appeared in Blackwood magazine. "Before the Congo, I was just a mere animal," stated Conrad. The novel is the author's longest journey into itself. It becomes obvious to the reader that the story is not about Kurds or the cruelty of the Belgians, but it is all about Marlowe's journey into self. The novel stands for human's morality and psychological deterioration and intellectual understanding the essential self. Let's now look into the setting of the novel. The story of Marlowe's travel up the Thames River makes the setting. Going up the river was like traveling back to the earliest beginnings of the world. It was something like an empty stream, a great silence, and an impenetrable forest. There was lazy, warm, and thick air, and no joy in the brilliance of sunshine. The waterway ran on long stretches into the shady distances. There were hippos and alligators on silvery sandbanks. Marlowe compares sailing up the river to going back in time. Marlowe tells us the story on a different river, the English Thames. The Thames is the Congo. England is like Africa, and white men are black men. At the very beginning of the novel, Marlowe says, "And this also has been one of the dark places of the earth." In other words, it provides a hint to the reader that England too was a place of primitive darkness until noblemen from Rome conquered it. In merry old England, during a flood, the British ship Nelly anchors near London. It awaits the flood to recede. The reader is introduced to four seamen on board: the unnamed narrator, a lawyer, an accountant, and Marlowe, and few others. Marlowe is mentioned to be without a specific profession. Marlowe has had a great passion for travel and exploration. He has a great desire for maps. The only thing that he wants is to be the captain of a steamship that travels up and down a river in Africa. His aunt, who seems to have got connected with the administration department of a seafaring and exploration company gathering ivory, manages to get an appointment for Marlowe. In a serious conflict with the natives, the captain is killed and Marlowe is replaced as captain. The atmosphere looks very dim and foreboding when Marlowe arrives at the company office. It appears for him as if everyone looks at him with pity. The doctor asks if there is a history of mania in Marlowe's family. Marlowe is told that nothing could persuade him to join the company down in the Congo. Marlowe is puzzled but does not pay any attention to it. The next day, he involves in a 1 month journey to the primary company station. A young boy approaches Marlowe. He looks very empty. Marlowe, unable to do anything, offers him some ship biscuits. He then comes across a very well-dressed man who stands for respectability and elegance. Marlowe is relieved to leave the boy and get introduced to this man. In the conversation, Marlowe learns that he is the chief accountant of the company. Marlowe befriends this man. He begins to spend most of his time in his hut while the accountant goes over the accounts. On observing the chief accountant's ill temper after 10 days, Marlowe departs for his 200-mile journey into the interior of the Congo, where he works for a station run by a man named Kurtz. Here we are introduced to Kurtz. The journey is laborious and difficult. Marlowe encounters black men working while crossing several paths. On his way, he also looks at deserted dwellings. Marlowe does not like them to call humans. Throughout the novel, these people are referred to in animalistic terms. Marlowe finally arrives at a secondary station where he meets the manager who for then oversees his work. The meeting appears strange. The manager smiles in a very unpleasant and dejected manner. Suddenly, the ship on which Marlowe is supposed to set sail breaks. Marlowe has had to wait till rivets are fixed to it. He gets more time to spend than on more mundane tasks. He frequently hears the name Kurtz around the station. Everyone clearly knows that his illness is a rumor. Soon, the entire crew will depart for a trip to Kurtz station. When we look into the character of Marlowe, Conrad's state of mind and his values is reflected in the novel. Conrad is seen undeniably in almost every event through Marlowe in the novel. Marlowe is Conrad's alter ego. Marlowe is an experienced captain with sunken cheeks, a yellow complexion, and an honest, active, rough, and sympathetic ascetic. He looks civilized and speaks in a gentle manner and stands as a good man of his time. As he goes deeper into the heart of the forest in search of Kurtz, he begins to know that savagery is a primitive form of civilization. Marlowe is the protagonist and the main character of the story. He also reflects his Victorian predecessors. In many ways, he looks a typical European. He is an independent thinker and a capable man. He is tough and honest. Marlowe concentrates between the intellectuals and that of the working tough. He is intelligent and eloquent and a natural philosopher. He is highly skilled at his actions. He repairs and pilots his own ship skillfully. He is not a mere manual labor. Work for him is a strong alternative to the excuse making of those around him. He possesses good work ethic. Thus, he is intended to be a versatile character. Marlowe is understood as an intermediate agent between the two extremes of Kurtz and the company. The reader is allowed to read and identify him. Marlowe acts as a guide for the reader. He is unlike those company men who focus on money and advancement, but like the one as Coleridge's ancient mariner, destined to repeat his story to all those who would listen. He is philosophical, independent-minded, and skeptical of those around him. He is an eloquent master storyteller. When Marlowe could know about the activities of Kurtz in the forest, he criticized Kurtz's moral collapses because of his separation from his culture and civilization. Marlowe was not cruel towards the blacks. Instead, he considered the pain of the native workers. Marlowe hates the cruel treatment of the natives that works with Kurtz. He tries to get Kurtz out of the Congo River, but Kurtz dies. During his journey to find Kurtz, Marlowe finds his true self. Thus, Marlowe's journey can be interpreted as a descent into the unconscious. When Marlowe returned to Europe, he found the people's nature offensive. That must have been the reason why his opening lines narrate about Romans' conquest of England. And Marlowe then speaks one of the darkest places of the earth. What Marlowe did was hiding the immortality present in a heart, as he knew well that there is a darker side in every human along with the brighter side. Let's look now into the character of Kurtz. Kurtz is a fictional character who stands as an example for civilized man. He switches over to barbaric attitude due to Congo environment. His mother is half English and his father half French. All Europe contributes to make Kurtz. He is a man of talent, interested in reading and writing poetry. He is the chief of the inner station and the reason for Marlowe's trip. He is a man of talents and has the capability to lead and control the natives. He did what he wanted to, as there were no rules and laws that would restrain him from doing so. He struggles with the darkness in himself, but finally at the end he realizes his folly and confesses to it. Kurtz is in charge of the most productive ivory station in the Congo. He is approved universally for his intelligence and eloquence. Kurtz becomes the focus of Marlowe's journey into Africa. He is the unique victim of colonization. Like Marlowe, Kurtz can be studied in a broader sense. He is captured by the wilderness. He turns his back on the people and customs that were once a part of him. In a world of mundanely malicious men, it is very difficult to get attention to be worthy of something that indeed is not deserved of. Kurtz can be criticized in the same manner. His style entirely overrules substance. It provides a justification for no moral standards and instead evil. Kurtz really racks in substance. Marlowe refers to Kurtz as hollow more than once. This can be taken in a negative sense to mean that Kurtz is not worthy of contemplation. On his visiting Kurtz's cousin, the Belgian journalist, and Kurtz's fiancée, Marlowe understands that there seems to be no true Kurtz. To his cousin, he was a great musician, and to the journalist, a brilliant politician and leader of men, and finally to his fiancée, a great humanitarian and genius. Here a reader can easily read Kurtz in contrast with Marlowe, yet through his charisma he remains with Marlowe and with the reader till the end. Kurtz takes up immoral acts because he is away from culture and civilization. Conrad deals with dark heart that lies in humanity. He strongly believes that apart from the brighter side, there is always the darker side in every human. Kurtz's last words, the horror, exemplifies two aspects. One being Marlowe experiencing change in Kurtz's personality, and the other being the invasion of the Congo. But later he lost his personality. Marlowe says that Kurtz's last words are a moral victory paid by innumerable defeats. Though Kurtz was immoral in many ways, he was successful because he did not run away from the truth. Let's look now into the character of Kurtz. Kurtz is a fictional character who stands as an example for civilized man. He switches over to barbaric attitude due to Congo environment. His mother is half English and his father half French. All Europe contributes to make Kurtz. He is a man of talent, interested in reading and writing poetry. He is the chief of the inner station and the reason for Marlowe's trip. He is a man of talents and has the capability to lead and control the natives. He did what he wanted to, as there were no rules and laws that would restrain him from doing so. He struggles with the darkness in himself. But finally, at the end, he realizes his folly and confesses to it. Kurtz is in charge of the most productive ivory station in the Congo. He is approved universally for his intelligence and eloquence. Kurtz becomes the focus of Marlowe's journey into Africa. He is the unique victim of colonization. Like Marlowe, Kurtz can be studied in a broader sense. He is captured by the wilderness. He turns his back on the people and customs that were once a part of him. In a world of mundanely malicious men, it is very difficult to get attention to be worthy of something that indeed is not deserved of. Kurtz can be criticized in the same manner. His style entirely overrules substance. It provides a justification for no moral standards and instead evil. Kurtz really lacks in substance. Marlowe refers to Kurtz as hollow more than once. This can be taken in a negative sense to mean that Kurtz is not worthy of contemplation. On his visiting Kurtz's cousin, the Belgian journalist, and Kurtz's fiancé, Marlowe understands that there seems to be no true Kurtz. To his cousin, he was a great musician, and to the journalist, a brilliant politician and leader of men, and finally to his fiancé, a great humanitarian and genius. Here a reader can easily read Kurtz in contrast with Marlowe, yet through his charisma, he remains with Marlowe and with the reader till the end. Kurtz takes up immoral acts because he is away from culture and civilization. Conrad deals with dark heart that lies in humanity. He strongly believes that apart from the brighter side, there is always the darker side in every human. Kurtz's last words, the horror, exemplifies two aspects. One being Marlowe experiencing change in Kurtz's personality, and the other being the invasion of the Congo. But later he lost his personality. Marlowe says that Kurtz's last words are a moral victory paid by innumerable defeats. Though Kurtz was immoral in many ways, he was successful because he did not run away from the truth. Heart of Darkness explores the exploitation of hidden dark regions more powerfully than any of the author's other novels. Conrad wrote this novel to examine civilization. Freud says, civilization describes the whole sum of the achievements and regulations which distinguish our lives from those of our animal ancestors, which serve two purposes, namely to protect men against nature and to adjust their mutual relations. This makes the reader think that Marlowe's journey is a psychological journey. The title of the book is a metaphor. The real darkness is not in Africa, but has originated from Europe. The Congo colonizers and their mistreatment towards their natives is well described. The novel has begotten a world of materialistic morality, inappropriate social modes, and aggressive values. The domino pieces, the keyboard, the Belgian woman knitting black wool, wearing a white dress. Dark eyes in a pale face and shrunken black heads with white teeth signify the imperialism. To conclude, Heart of Darkness is not just a fiction. It shows the suffering of millions of Africans who suffered and died due to brutality of Europeans during their trading and colonization. Marlowe finally understands that his greatest adventure in his life is death. He quotes, "Dark human shapes could be made out in the distance, flitting indistinctly against the gloomy border of the forest." The story ends as Marlowe and his listeners look at the waterway of the Thames flowing on to the Heart of Darkness. Thus, the novel shows how the man is controlled by the nature. I hope you all have seen how Joseph Conrad had traveled into his self. Well, this session tells us about Victorian values and imperialism and also modernism. Thank you.